I don't even know if I remember how to do this anymore. Holy crap. Get the lipstick on. Okay, I think we're ready to film.
Hey guys, as you can tell from the title of this video, we're doing a simple life update. I don't typically do these kinds of videos because, I don't know, sometimes I'm like, gosh, do people even really care? And I have a very small channel, so that's why I think that. But you know what, I was just gonna put this out there, film a little life update, tell you guys what I've been up to, just so you guys feel like you're a part of my, you know, life, and that I, you know, you guys are important to me. I had every intention of filming the last couple of weeks, but you know, sometimes you just have to take a little back step on the YouTube and focus on your family and stuff like that. So I just wanted to say welcome to any new subscribers. You guys have been commenting. I think a few people found my giveaway on my ColourPop video. So thank you for subscribing if you did. If you didn't catch my giveaway, my palette collection video, the first one, just went live and I showed you guys all my ColourPop palettes, and I actually forgot to include, not forgot, I filmed that video before I got my Kathleen Lights Zodiac palette. So if you guys are wondering if I have that palette or not, I do have it and I want to review it for you guys. So yeah, let me know if that's something you're interested in. I feel like it came out a while ago, but you guys know I'm way behind on reviews, so it is what it is. Anyway, the reason I wasn't on here is because my parents were in town. If you follow my Instagram, you probably saw us doing stuff, but they were here pretty much all of August, and it was so fun. Usually I get to see my mom once a year or so, but this time my dad actually joined her here. So we had both my parents, and I'm an only child, and it was just really fun. We just got to hang out every night. And of course, my mom is an amazing cook. So her and my dad made us a lot of food and spoiled us a little bit, which was great. And we got to spoil them. And we just got to do like a lot of fun things in Fargo. We went to Minneapolis, showed them the cities. They got to try a roller coaster for the first time. Just doing fun stuff that you kind of take for granted when your parents live here, but it was just nice to spend time with them and yeah, have them like meet some of our friends. And we did a chili cook-off. Our friend's family hosts one every Labor Day weekend. So my mom got to do that and she got to toss bean bags. And so yeah, we just had a really great time. If you guys want to go see, I have an update on, or a highlight on my Instagram, you know, profile, just showing like some of the stuff me and my parents did while they were here on vacation, if you guys are interested in that. Also, my Instagram handle is of course down in the description box. So we did that, and they actually, the day I'm filming this is the day they left. Yesterday was their actual flight, and somehow it was weird. I feel like I could make a whole video about this, but American Airlines basically claimed that they missed their flight, but actually their flight took off early, and we never heard any like boarding calls because me and my husband were also at the airport dropping them off. An airport is very small, so that was an unfortunate experience, but they were able to reschedule. They got on their plane today, so they're on their way back home. As I'm filming this, they're probably in the air somewhere over, I don't even know, because they're flying via the Middle East, so they're probably almost to the Middle East by now. No, actually, I think they got a long way to go. You guys, if you ever fly across the world, like, so to get home from me, I have to fly from Fargo to Chicago usually, which is an hour, and then Chicago to London is how I usually fly, which is a 10-hour flight, and then London to Sri Lanka is a 10-hour flight, a direct flight. If you fly through the Middle East, it's typically longer. So the last time I flew Chicago to Qatar, which is about a 13-hour flight. And if you've ever been on a plane for 13 hours, I promise you, you're ready to get off of it at like hour 5. So it's a really like terrible trip. I mean, I know people say they love flying and they love travel, and I do too. I love to travel, but holy crap, like that amount of time is ridiculous. So yeah, I just applaud people that do that. It always like blows my mind when I see how much beauty influencers travel, because I mean, they're like constantly in the air and the time zones, and like, I know people get jealous because it's like, oh my God, they're here one day and they're in Morocco one day and they're in Bali one day. But having done like lengthy trips like that, I'm just like, you know what? I don't think I could be that, like, in that top tier of like beauty guru, because they don't stop. And like, they're in Japan, they're in Australia. I mean, sometimes I watch Desi Perkins' Instagram stories and I'm like, I don't know how she has the energy to be on a flight like that and then get off a plane and look flawless the way she does. But you know, that's their life. Anyway, so that's that. And then talking about travel, in the meantime, it's actually my 30th year on this planet. So my 30th birthday is coming up. I don't know what I'm trying to say right now. So my 30th birthday is coming up. And if you guys don't know, I actually got my green card this year. So it basically means I'm allowed to travel out of the United States and not like have to worry about stuff. If you want to see my like immigrant video, I have it. I'll try and remember to link it up in the cards for you guys. But yeah, that's another story. So just go watch that video because I don't want to like recap that video. Anyway, so one of my thoughts was if I were to get my green card, I wanted me and my husband to do an overseas trip because we're both from other places, but we've never traveled overseas together. And being at my 30th birthday this year and my green card and our anniversary, our birthdays, like all of that stuff. Anyway, so I was like, God, I really want to go to Paris. Like, it's just like one of those cities. You know, if you're a fashionista, if you love art, if you love good food, if you want to see the Eiffel Tower, like you want to go to Paris. So I really, really wanted to go in December, which is my birthday month, but the flights were just kind of over the top pricey. And I have a group of friends and they constantly are traveling. And so one of my friends was talking about how she had found cheap flights to Europe in February. And so after talking to her, I was just on like online looking, and I found tickets to Paris from Fargo. Keep in mind, this is a ridiculous deal. We found them for under $600. So we ended up, we're flying to Paris in 2019. We're going in February. So if any of my friends and subscribers, friends, are from France or specifically Paris, please let me know like all of your recommendations. Holy crap, first of all, or if you've ever been to Paris, because I don't really know if anybody watches me from France, but if you've ever been to Paris or, you know, anything, let me know. If you are a subscriber from Paris, I would love to figure out a way to meet you guys. So yeah, I mean, this is like a once in a lifetime trip. You know, I don't think we'll ever go back to Paris, and we're there for quite some time. So I'll give you guys more information the closer we get to our trip and stuff. And then if you have any video ideas, like travel related video ideas, let me know. Like I said, I don't travel overseas very often. Yes, I did go to Sri Lanka this year, but that was more taking care of stuff, and it's my home, so I didn't think of it as like, oh my God, this major travel, like I went to Sri Lanka, like I'm so fancy. I'm so excited to be going to Paris. And yeah, so that's another life update. The other thing I wanted to talk to you guys about is just some channel updates. Now that things have died down, we have a little more time. I was thinking of my goals for my channel. One of the big ones, I really want to hit 2K this year, and I feel like I can do it, but I had a really good momentum going, and then, you know, we had people come in and stuff like that, and I felt like I kind of lost that traction. So I'm at about 1700 right now, and I'm hoping we can end the year with 2K. So yeah, fingers crossed on that. And then I wanted to tell you guys too, I have some playlists that I've been creating, and I'm so proud of my playlist because I have quite a few playlists on my channel. And so I have one that's called Stay Woke, which is a really fun one. I was trying to figure out what to name it, and I just thought Stay Woke was so relevant because that was like such a buzzword this year. And in that one, I just put like drama videos or like people that have really interesting opinions on drama that's happening in the community right now. Just people that I trust and like here for the tea videos, like just good ones that I like, because there's a lot of garbage videos on drama. But this one's a really good one. Or I'll do like, you know, brands that like products I'm not happy with, just stuff that I want to bring like awareness to. So I really like that playlist. And then I have a playlist called YouTube Channels I Love. And so basically what I try to do on there is I will add channels that I watch frequently, or a video from a channel that I personally am subscribed to that I want you guys to see. So that one I'm really proud of, because the creators on there are people that typically upload regularly, and yeah, they just are doing good job. And so I love that one, and it's personal to me because it's my taste. And I had meant to film channels I'm subscribed to video, or like YouTube channels that you should be subscribed to kind of video. And I had, you know, made this long list, and I was like, you know what? I feel like it would be better for me to create a playlist because I'm constantly finding new channels. So this is a great way for me to feature them. So on there, you're gonna find people like Mel Thomas? I can't remember her name, but she used to be Puffin's wife on YouTube. Her channel I found pretty recently. She's beautiful. Angelica Nyquist, of course. Georgia Harris, Spooky Lips and Fat Hips, The Fancy Faced, Amy Loves Makeup, Paulina Beauty. Like, there's so many people, and I'm sorry if I don't mention everyone, that I watch on a daily basis that are on there. Samantha March. Yeah, the list is endless. I'm gonna stop now, but go check it out. I will try and remember to link it at the end of this video. Because I love that playlist, and it's called YouTube Channels I Love, if you're looking that up. So I wanted to mention that. Now the thing I want to tell you guys is I do have an active giveaway on my channel right now. I mentioned it at the beginning. It's a ColourPop video. My ColourPop palette collection has a giveaway on it. I want you guys to go ahead and watch that video and enter, because of course I want one of my subscribers to win a makeup palette from ColourPop, of course. Check that out. And of course, I have more giveaways coming, so get excited. Also, if you don't follow me on Instagram, you guys really should. My life is pretty boring, but I do post on my stories quite often, just talking about random things and, you know, this and that. And so I really like Instagram stories. I don't know about you guys. So yeah, check me out on Instagram. I feel like I'm definitely active there more on a daily basis. As far as my YouTube schedule, if you guys don't know this about me, I upload every other day. So it's usually even days. I don't know. It's just like a great way for me to stay on schedule. I couldn't do every day because it's just too much. So I decided to do every other day. So I upload every second, fourth, sixth, eighth, like even numbers. And so then once you get to the 30th of the month, I upload on the 30th, 31st, or if it's like a longer month, I won't upload on the 31st or the 1st, I'll upload on the 2nd. So that's kind of my schedule, and then usually my videos go live at 7 a.m. Central Time. So yeah, just wanted to let you know if you're new to my channel. The other thing I want to do is talk about potentially starting a book club on my channel. I don't know if anybody else does this. I haven't really looked at book club videos, but what I thought I would do is maybe pick a book and kind of like announce in a video like which book I'm gonna read that month, and then maybe pick a particular day of the month where I'll just kind of upload a video talking about like if I like the book, what I like about the book, blah blah blah, and then we can have some good discussion in the comments. I don't know, I just thought of it. It's kind of like, I love self-help books, so if that's something that interests you guys, let me know. If not, I'm just gonna read the books and maybe share on Instagram. So let me know if you have thoughts on that, or if somebody else is already doing a book club on YouTube. I'm interested. I don't really want to do book reviews. It's partially a review, but I also want to let you guys hear you guys' thoughts and also just share, like, especially because I want to read like all like feminism books or like How to Be a Badass. Like, I started reading that and I never finished it, so it's kind of a way to hold myself accountable too, because I love media. Like, if I'm not watching YouTube, I'm watching TV, and books are kind of like on the back burner, even though I buy a lot of books. So yeah, just an idea. Let me know what you think. Oh, I wanted to like lightly touch on the drama in the beauty community. I feel like there's a lot of it, so this video is definitely not going to be long enough for me to talk about all of the drama, but I feel like it is really, really sad. I don't know. I feel like the people that are going to follow those big YouTubers will always follow them. I follow certain people that you might not like, and you know, it is what it is. We can't change people's opinions that they have. I feel like that's something I learned this year through YouTube. It's like, I used to get so mad every time somebody mentioned Morphe on their channel, because I'm like, you know what? Morphe's crap. But you know what? At the end of the day, when the Jaclyn Hill vault came out, I did place an order. And so I'm like, Karen, you're just feeding right into it. So you can't tell people who to like. It's just going to turn into a shit show. You're always going to be disappointed. So just, you know, have your opinion and let other people have their opinions. And it is what it is, I think. I do think it's interesting because I'm not subscribed to Manny or Laura. I haven't been for a really, really long time. Those are people that I used to be interested in, but I feel like they just, you could just tell like Manny was a user. Like if you are a long time YouTube watcher, you could see that happening in his personality. I watched him use Marlena from Makeup Geek, and I remember like how him and Jaclyn Hill were so close. Like he used to be in a lot of these people's videos when he was a lot smaller of a channel, which is when I used to watch him. So yeah, I think it just comes with the territory and the crazy paychecks, and like that is so far removed from regular people's lives. It's like you kind of, it's like watching people crash and burn, and it's like, well, you know, it's like watching a car crash and you can't do anything to save anybody because it just happens, you know? So it's interesting. Try not to let it get you too down, because in reality, there's so many other YouTubers out there, and I've heard so many people preach that. So yeah, hopefully you guys are feeling a little bit better about the drama, and to those people, like, whatever, like, they don't affect my life, so I don't really care about it. I mean, I care, but I don't, like, emotionally, I'm not, like, in turmoil about it, because it's like, what did you expect? Okay, and then I wanted to just really quick touch on some palettes I'm looking forward to. I have been, like, salivating over all the new releases. I feel like September is gonna be, like, an epic month for makeup, and I've just been, like, so some of the palettes I want, Pat McGrath palette for sure, and I just started talking to some other YouTubers, and I don't know if this is something where I can't announce. I don't know, is it an announcement? Who cares? Like, I don't know. But we're working on a very exciting collaboration with some YouTubers that maybe love Pat McGrath, and so I'm really, really excited for that. I hope it all works out the way we think it's going to, so that's exciting. So I'm excited for Pat McGrath's next palette. She is amazing. I'm excited to see the Gingerbread palette. You guys, I bought the Too Faced Tutti Frutti palette. I'll show you guys that in a haul, and I talked about it on Instagram already. It's stellar. Like, the quality of those shadows, I mean, I've only worn them twice on my eyeballs, but I was really freaking impressed by that palette. So good for Too Faced, you know, for really like taking in all their negativity and trying to do something positive. Even though they're regurgitating a lot of the fruity themes, I'm still pretty impressed with the fact that they've at least upped their quality. Their packaging is cute. I mean, they're doing a decent job, so good for them. What else am I looking forward to? Oh, I really want the new Tatcha lip balm thing. Looks amazing. I want those new Huda palettes, holy shit. So yeah, I need to go ahead and film a Will I Buy It video, but yeah, those are just kind of like some life updates. Let me know if you enjoyed this type of video, otherwise it was like a total snooze fest. I'm like so sorry, but I really just wanted to come on here and like tell you guys what I was actually doing the last couple of weeks. And you know, hopefully you guys can forgive me and keep watching and supporting. I really, really appreciate it, you guys. And I missed my YouTube family so much because I love talking to you guys. And I feel like every time I upload a video, there's like consistently people that comment, and that's how I interact with these people. So like, I miss reading those comments, and yeah, I'm back. So hopefully I don't foresee any like impending visitors or reasons why I won't be able to film in the next year, like in the next, what is left of 2018. And I just wanna say thank you guys for your support. Enter that giveaway. I will list everything in the description or at the end of this video, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Bye.